Hey there, mathematicians! It's Justin again. Mia's family members have been visiting and sharing some great multiplication and division fact strategies. And today, Mia's grandpa, Nate, invited us to play a round of miniature golf with him at Miaville Putt-Putt. Nate is also Tulip and Forrest's grandpa. Tulip helped us with our twos, Forrest helped us with our fours, and today Grandpa Nate is going to help us with our eights. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to make connections to help you confidently multiply and divide by eight. Have your guide to notes ready, and let's swing into action. Maybe we'll even get a hole in one. Grandpa Nate left us with some warm-up problems to solve while he's taken his turn at hole number one. Ooh, that ramp looks tricky. Okay, pause here to solve 2 times 5, 4 times 5, 8 times 5, 24 divided by 2, 24 divided by 4, and 24 divided by 8. Ooh, nice job, Nate. All right, Mia, you're up. Mathematicians, let's check our answers. 2 times 5 equals 10, 4 times 5 equals 20, and 8 times 5 equals 40. While 24 divided by 2 equals 12, 24 divided by 4 equals 6, and 24 divided by 8 equals 3. Are you noticing a pattern with these multiplication problems? And the division problems? Notice anything familiar there? This reminds me of the fact family work we did with Tulip and Forrest, when we discovered that the 2's and 4's fact families are related. Oh, Grandpa Nate says 8's are also related to 2's and 4's, like how Nate is also Tulip and Forrest's grandpa. With Forrest, we learned that knowing our 2's means we can double our product to help us multiply by 4, or split our quotient in half to help us divide by 4. So, how can we use this knowledge to help us multiply and divide by 8? Well, we can actually use our 4's and even our 2's to help. See if you can figure out how on your own first, and then we'll check it out together when you're done. In your guide to notes, try using related facts to help you solve 8 times 7 and 40 divided by 8. Okay, let's check these out together. Since 8 is twice as much as, or double, 4, we can use 4 times 7 to help us solve 8 times 7. If you know 4 times 7, then you can double that and have your answer to 8 times 7. But if you're not quite sure about 4 times 7, you could also try doing 2 times 7 first. 2 times 7 equals 14. We can double that to help us solve 4 times 7. 14 and 14 is 28. And then we can double that to help us with 8 times 7. 28 and 28 is 56. That means 8 times 7 equals 56. And 40 divided by 8? Well, 40 divided by 4 equals 10. So that means 40 divided by 8 is half that amount, or 5. Just like Mia's family, related fact families are super helpful. So Mia's score is 4 for the first hole, Nate's score is 2, and my score is 3. Let's head to the next one. While Grandpa Nate takes his turn, let's examine the multiples of 8 on the 100 chart, in the list, or both. Are any patterns starting to emerge? Check out how the digits change from one multiple to the next, or the way they shift on the 100 chart. Pause and record at least one observation or pattern in your guided notes. Did you notice how the digit in the ones place follows a pattern? It goes 8, 6, 4, 2, 0, and repeats. And that's not just a randomly repeating pattern, that's a descending pattern. The digit in the ones place keeps getting smaller and smaller, and then it starts again back at 8. This pattern could be really helpful when counting by multiples of 8. Give it a try. We have a list of multiples that are missing some digits. 32, 40, 48, 50-something, 64, 70-something, 80. What digits are missing from the multiples based on that descending pattern? After 48 comes 56. Then after 64 comes 72. Skip counting like this is another great tool to use when solving multiplication and division problems. And as we already know, the more we practice, the more progress we make. It's up to you to decide when and how to use certain strategies. You may discover that you can quickly and confidently solve many of your 8's, but if you ever find yourself stuck, you can always use your 4's and even your 2's to help. And knowing all these strategies doesn't mean that you have to use them all. It's about learning what strategies work best for you and then deciding how to approach each problem. So, what have we learned today besides the fact that Nate's a natural when it comes to navigating his 8's? Well, now you know that 2's, 4's, and 8's are related fact families. Multiplying by 8 is the same as multiplying by 4 and then doubling the product, while dividing by 8 is the same as dividing by 4 and splitting the quotient in half. You also know that the ones place digit in multiples of 8 follows a descending pattern and will always be an 8, 6, 4, 2, or 0. This pattern can help us efficiently skip count by multiples of 8 and check our work. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice multiplying and dividing by 8. Whoa, Grandpa Nate got a hole in one on that last one. Nice job. Okay, so now Mia's score is 9, Nate's score is 3, and my score is 5. You are quite the golfer, Mia. You scored more points than either of us combined. Wait, it's about having the fewest points in golf? Huh. Well, then I guess Nate won. Either way, that was a lot of fun. Grandpa Nate, do you know who's helping us next? Oh, of course, Grandma Adeline. And she wants to invite us over to do some baking? Ugh, Grandma Adeline makes the best treats. I wonder what we're gonna make this time. Well, thank you for helping us with our 8's today, Nate. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. I'll see you next time. Hey.